Subject is English of standard 3rd and the name of the poem is Dress Quickly. Dear students, daily you wear uniform to school, right? Uniform for boys includes shirt, half pant, socks, shoes, and for girls it is pinafore, ribbons, belt, socks and shoes, isn't it? Students, sometimes you don't get socks or ribbons in hurry, correct? So, to overcome these types of problems, today we will have some solutions. Let us move to the poem Dress Quickly to get the solutions to our routine problems. Okay? Yes, students, you can see here two pictures of two children. Right? Now, can you tell me with whom would you like to have friendship? The first one, a boy in tidy clothes, or the second one, the boy in untidy clothes? Yes, dear students. Yes, I know that you like to have friendship with the first boy who is in tidy clothes and who is clean, isn't it? Okay. Dear students, on page number 19, there is a poem named Dress Quickly. This is your page. Okay, we will go through this poem by stanza. Okay, it has three stanzas and poem is written by a poet, Gillett Burgess. Dress Quickly is the heading of this poem. All your life you will have to dress every single day unless you should happen to be sick. Then why not learn to do it quick? Yes, these are the four lines of first stanza. Here it means you wear clothes daily. If you have school, then you wear uniform. And if you want to go out, then you wear colorful dresses. Right? Means wearing clothes is necessary. Then why not learn to do it quick? Hang your clothes the proper way. See, this child is hanging her clothes in proper way. So, you will find them fresh next day. Correct? Treat them with a little care. Fold them neatly on a chair. You can see here, children, they are taking care of their clothes and that boy is folding his clothes. Correct? Now, here, if we keep our clothes properly by hanging them, we will easily get whenever we are. Clothes also last for long because you are taking care of them, isn't it? You know, dear students, our personality matters and clothes help us to get a perfect personality. So, respect and take care of your clothes. So, without a bit of worry, you can dress in quite a hurry. See, these two children, they got their clothes without any problem. So, they are becoming ready because they kept their clothes in proper way. Think of the slovenly groups before. You strew your clothing on the floor. You know, goops means a stupid person. Always try to remember these slovenly means untidy goops before strewing clothes means spreading your clothes anyhow on the floor. See, this is the third picture of a boy means that he is a goop. And see here, strewing means scattering the clothes on the floor. So dear students, I hope you will take care of your clothes and you will keep them in the proper way. Okay. The poem is written by Gillette Burgess. Yeah, we will go through some of the hard words. Slovenly means, see this picture. The meaning is untidy. Goops. See, this is a goop. Means a stupid person. He is sitting on the branch and he is cutting that same branch. Strew means, see this picture, things scattered here and there. You can see the papers scattered throughout the room. Cloth, you know this? Now we will move to the grammar part, rhyming words. First we will go through some of the examples and then we will go to the meaning. Okay, see the first picture, dog, and after that it is log. See, read this, dog, log. Okay, how they sound? They sound similar, isn't it? Dog, log. So, the words which sound similar are called as rhyming words. Their spellings are different and their meanings also different, but they sound similar. Then we call these pair of words as rhyming words. Okay? Now, second one, hen, pen. Jip, dip. For this, run, sun. See how they sound similar. Hat, cat. Got the students? Okay, these are called as rhyming words. Once again, I want to tell you that rhyming words are the words which sound similar. Okay? Now, circle the correct rhyming words. Now, first one is lad. Here, three options are given. We have to circle the correct word which rhymes with the lad. I will read. First one is map. Second is pad. And third is fit. Now, our word is lad. Then, again, lad, map. No, lad, pad. Yes, this pad rhymes with lad, isn't it? Okay, we'll move to the second one. Jet, this is nap. Wet, lip. Yes, the word which rhymes with jet is, yes, you are right, wet. Now we'll move to the third one. This is bug. This is dad. Bin. Mug. Bug. Dad. No. Bug. Bin. No. Bug. Mug. Yes. Correct. Mug is the answer. means mug rhymes with the bug. Got this? Now, dear students, this is our poem. Now, we will mark the rhyming words from this poem. See, first one. All your life you will have to dress every single day unless you should happen to be sick. Why not learn to do it quick? See, this dress, unless, they rhyme together. These are the pairs, dress, unless. See the sound. Give importance to the sound. Okay? Sick, quick. Correct? Then way, day. See the last words. Then care, chair. Then next, worry, hurry. Got the students? They sound similar. Before, flow. Yet these are all rhyming words. We will write them later on. Write the pairs of rhyming words you see at the end of the poem. See here, we will write the same thing here. Dress, unless, sick, quick. Correct? Way, day. Just now we circled in the poem. Same we are writing here. Care, chair. Worry, hurry. Before, flow. Now, this is one more grammar part. Okay. Make new words adding ly to the following words. Then use the new words in your own sentences. Means we have to do here two works. First, the given words, that is neat, slow. These are the given words. We have to add ly to the right side of these words. Means that is called as suffix. What? Suffix. Okay? Adding ly is called as suffix. When we add ly to the given word, that becomes adverb. Remember this, children. See, these neat, slow, are the adjectives. Means adjective means they are the describing words for nouns. See, for example, he is a good boy. You know that boy is a noun, isn't it? Good boy. Good, which is a word that describes about the boy. So that is called as adjective. Okay? And here also we can see neat and slow. These are adjectives. When we add ly to them, they become adverbs. Okay? And after that, we will use that adverbs to make the sentences. Okay? First one we will go through. Adjective is neat. N-E-A-T, neat. Now we will add ly to it, so it becomes neatly. How we read? Neatly. Okay. Then we are going to frame a sentence. See this? Write neatly. A simple sentence of only two words. Write neatly. Got this? Now second one is slow. Now we are going to convert it into adverb. Means we are adding ly to slow. So it becomes slowly. Then we are going to frame the sentence using the word slowly. See this? When I feel tired, I walk slowly. You can make any of your sentence. But only one condition is there, that adverb here, whichever the word is given, that should be there in that sentence. Some more adjectives are there. This is from your textbook. Okay, the adjective is nice. Now I will add ly to it, means suffix, correct? So it becomes nicely, isn't it? Now our sentence is, we must always behave nicely with everyone. Okay, the next one is proper. This is an adjective. Okay, now we are going to make it an adverb, means we are going to add ly. So it is properly. The sentence is, Rama finally learned to operate computer properly. This next one is loud. Now we are going to add ly, so it became loudly. Do not shout so loudly. Got this? Got the meaning? The next one is soft, and the adverb is softly, and the sentence is, the little girl called the kitten softly. Last one is clear. This is an adjective. We are going to add ly, then it became clearly. And the sentence framed is, I can see the rainbow clearly. I can see the dog clearly. Anything you can write here. Okay. Now, dear students, see this. Read the following and circle the things that the goops would do. You know that goops means a stupid person. Okay, something is given here, phrases are given, and some sentences are also given, means you can see here different actions. Now some actions are good and some actions are bad. The things that the goofs would do means really, of course, it is bad actions. Goofs means stupid persons, correct? Means they make the bad actions. So dear students, we will see these actions through the picture, then it will become clear for you, isn't it? This is the first one. Speak with their mouth full. See, this man is eating and he is speaking, means here he is praying from his mouth. Whatever he is eating, that is coming out from his mouth. Okay, remember the action. Okay, second one, cover their mouth when they sneeze. This girl is sneezing and she is covering her mouth with a handkerchief. This is the second action. You have to bifurcate as the good action and as the bad action. Which actions are followed by the goofs, we have to decide. So remember, third one is put muddy footprints on the bed. See, you can see muddy footprints on the bed. The next one is spit on the road. See, this man is spitting on the road, and on the wall it is written, do not spit. Then also that man is spitting on the road. Next one is flush the toilet properly. Next, wipe dirty hands on their clothes. See this boy, he is cleaning his hands with his clothes. Come on, dear students. Now, from these six actions, can you classify which of these actions are made by the goops, means a stupid person? Okay, we will circle them. Come on, tell me. Yes, you are right. First one, speak with their mouth full. Yes, whenever we are of mouth full, we should not talk. Correct? Now, this is also a wrong one. We should not step on the bed sheet with our muddy legs or muddy chappals. Next is spitting on the road. Yes, this is also a wrong thing. We should not do this because this is our society. Correct? So we must keep our surroundings clean. And spitting causes diseases, isn't it? Next one is this one, wiping dirty hands on the clothes. Yes, you are right, students. These four actions, they are bad actions. Some more actions are there. See here, pick their nose. E. Switch off fans and lights while leaving a room. See here, fan and lights, they are switched off because no one is there in that room. Push people on the stairs. See that first man, he is pushing the second man on the stairs. See again, bifurcate the actions into good actions and bad actions. Okay? Wait in a queue. Use other people's things without their permission. Some students, they take the eraser, they take pencil, they take compass box, anything they take of their friends and they don't ask them. This is a bad habit, isn't it? Next, throw garbage in a dustbin. Here also you can see six actions. Some are good and some are bad. Bad actions are done by goops, means stupid persons. You are not going to do all that bad actions, isn't it? Okay, now here also we will circle the bad actions. First one is picking his nose. Next one is pushing people on the stairs, not to harm anyone, right? Next is this one, using other people's things without their permission, without asking, not to take anything of your friends. For this, these are all actions followed by the goops. And we are not goops, isn't it? Yes, here the same thing is there. Now here we will circle the sentences. First one, speak with their mouth. Yes, this is wrong thing. Second, cover their mouth when they sneeze. Good thing. Next, put muddy footprints on the bed. Again, bad. Just now we saw this. Next, spit on the roads. Bad things. Flush the toilet properly, means cleaning the toilet after use. Very good thing. Next, wipe dirty hands on their clothes. Untidiness. Bad thing. Pick their nose. Very bad thing. Switch off fans and lights while leaving a room. good thing. Push people on the stairs, bad thing. Correct? Wait in a queue, good thing. Use other people's things without their permission, very bad thing. We have to ask their permission. We have to kindly, we have to ask, please give me, then they will give, then you can use that thing. But without asking, taking and using the thing is very bad habit. Okay? Throw garbage in a dustbin, good thing, because we have to keep our clean, our surroundings clean, isn't it? Thank you. Please go through this poem 2 to 3 times. Okay?